Hello and welcome. Here we are for more Saturday Gumbo. I'm Susan Shaw, and we got a special show lined up for you today. I'm going to tell you a little more about that. So yes, the show is going to be a little different today. We have a collaboration going on. I have with me Ken McCarthy. First, I want to tell you a little about him. You may already know him. He is from these parts or lives around these parts. I came across him first through Jazz on the Tube, which is a daily video that he sends out to people on his list of a live jazz performance. Just fantastic. A great thing to get in your mailbox with everything else you get in there. He was here last spring to talk about the roots of New Orleans music in Cuba. He had just come back from Cuba. So I discovered these mutual connections. It turned out he had made also a program for KZE, a two-hour program on what was going on in New Orleans after Katrina and the flood. That was quite a few years back, but he's always been interested in New Orleans, and he's gone further and deeper into the roots of New Orleans music. So I'm going to let Ken talk a bit about oh, and by the way, happy Thanksgiving to everybody out there. I think it's kind of cool to be doing a special show on this special weekend. So I'm bringing in Ken, and he's going to tell you why he wanted to do a show like this today.
Thank you so much, Susan, and thanks to KZE for having me. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody, and we're putting this show on together. It's a little bit like the show we did in the spring where we showed the Cuban roots, some of the Cuban roots of New Orleans music and culture. A lot of it hidden, a lot of it unknown. And tonight we're going to talk about the Haitian roots of New Orleans, which are actually go even deeper than the Cuban roots. And we're doing this as an awareness raise, and we're going to have fun. We're going to play great music, but it's also an awareness raising. As a lot of people know, there was a huge hurricane in Haiti not long ago, just a few months ago. And because of our, you know, the way the news works and so on and so forth, that has been forgotten. It's just completely out of the headlines, and there's still a great need there. So through the show, we're going to be talking a little bit here and there about things that you can do to help. But the main thing is Haiti is still there. Haiti still needs our help. And we're going to start out by playing a piece of music that's about as roots Haitian as you can get, and then we're going to seg from that into some of the New Orleans music that you'll suddenly realize came from somewhere other than New Orleans. And the first thing we're playing?
The first thing we're playing is Legba Nan Baeya. I think I said it right.
Yep.
Do you want to say anything particularly about that?
I was going to make a surprise, but let's say. So we all need to realize that a lot of our culture here in the Western Hemisphere comes from Africa, and a lot of it comes through the Caribbean. And there are different religions in Africa, and they're kind of like the Greek and Roman religions. You know, the Greeks and the Romans had the goddess of love and the god of war and so on. And the West Africans had a very similar setup with gods and spirits and entities related to certain forces. So we're going to hear a beautiful piece of music dedicated to the spirit of the doorway. And this is the kind of music that always begins a religious ceremony in Haiti.
Legba nan baeya, legba nan baeya, se ou ki kote do apo, se ou ka pa soleil pou loin yo.
Legba nan baeya, legba nan baeya, legba nan baeya, se ou ki kote do apo, se ou ka pa soleil pou loin yo.
Legba nan fawa, legba nan baeya.
Le
va no va ya, le va no va ya, le va no va ya, se u ki pote do apo, se u ka pa soleil pou loyo.
Se u ki pote do apo,
fire. My grandma told your grandma, I'm gonna set your flag on fire. Talking about henna, 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 Aiko, Aiko, Ande, Giacomo Fino, Anale, Giacomo Finale. Look at my king all dressed in red, Aiko, Aiko, Ande, I bet you $5 he'll kill you dead. Giacomo Finale. Talking about henna,
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 Aiko, Aiko, Ande, Giacomo Fino, Anande, Giacomo Finale. My flag boy and your flag boy sitting by the fire. My flag boy to your flag boy, I'm gonna set your flag on fire. Talking about henna,
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 Aiko, Aiko, Ande, Giacomo Fino, Anande, Giacomo Finale. See that guy all dressed in green, Aiko, Aiko, Ande, he not a man, he's a loving machine. Giacomo Finale. Talking about henna,
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 Aiko, Aiko, Ande, Giacomo Fino, Anande, Giacomo Finale. Talking about henna,
henna,
henna, Aiko, Aiko, Ande, Giacomo Fino, Anande, Giacomo Finale. Giacomo Finale.
Bye.
98.1 KZE. You are tuned to Saturday Gumbo, and I am here with Ken McCarthy, and we are talking about the roots of New Orleans music in Haiti. And since this is a collaboration, I'm letting Ken come in and talk about that last set.
Thanks, Susan. So we started out with Legba, which is a traditional spiritual piece. It is dedicated to the loi of the doorways. That if you know anything about Cuban stuff, that would be the equivalent of an orisha, or a god, or a spirit, whatever you want to call it. And it's a piece of music that's typically you always sung at the beginning of any kind of gathering. Then we went to the Dixie Cups, who recorded Ico Ico. And many of you may know that story, but they were just hanging around the studio one day, and they went into this a cappella thing, and the producer said, "What was that?" And it was New Orleans street music. And maybe you heard the connection between the thing that we heard at the beginning, Tuilegba, and the Dixie Cup piece. Maybe you heard it. Then we went into Dr. John, who took Ico Ico and blew it up with his genius. And then we went to the Wild Magnolias, their great music. It's Dr. John's birthday this week.
It was. He turned 76 on the 21st. And, man, I mean, he is a real New Orleans personage. There's no other place he could be, I don't think.
He might be the ultimate New Orleans guy.
Yeah.
And I had the pleasure of hanging out at his house one night and watching the Grammys with him when he was up for an award. And he said something really funny. He didn't win. He said, "I only got the... No, it was the Oscars, actually." He said, "I only got the wiener. I didn't get the other one." Because he didn't get the Oscar, Oscar Mayer. Oh, he got the Oscar Mayer. I forget how he put it. But, you know, he's got his own language. And people should know a little bit about Dr. John, if you're a fan of his music. He says his family came to New Orleans in the early part of the 1800s. Well, that would make him a French Creole from Haiti. A huge number of people escaped Haiti during the revolution there and went to New Orleans, doubling the size of the city in just 1 year. Also, Dr. John is a character, a real person, who was a competitor of Marie Laveau. He was a voodoo person. So if you're talking about Dr. John, you're talking about somebody who's got almost certainly roots right back to Haiti, which, by the way, was called Saint-Domingue when it was the French colony.
Yeah. You know, I mean, this is just perfect to do Saturday Gumbo and go back to all. I mean, New Orleans is the inspiration for this show and so much great music, and then to find out what inspired New Orleans, really. So we're going to keep it going with music from Haiti, inspired by Haiti, and Ken McCarthy when we come back. You're at 98.1 KZE, your home for musical diversity. And this is Saturday Gumbo. I'm here with Ken McCarthy. He's going to let us know what we're hearing next.
Okay. And, you know, that word gumbo, if I may, talk about it a little bit. We all hear it, and we all hear that New Orleans is a gumbo. How many people know that gumbo means okra in French? How many people know that okra comes from West Africa, so that when you say the word gumbo, you're invoking Africa and you're invoking the French Creoles. Speaking of the French Creoles, just very brief history. You know, France took over Western Hispaniola and turned it into a huge sugar plant, one massive sugar plantation. And they were very, very, very rich. It was the richest place in the Western Hemisphere. In fact, it was called Paris West. It was called the Pearl of the Antilles, and it was way ahead. And at the time that was going on in Saint-Domingue in Haiti, New Orleans was just, you know, a bunch of shacks, not much going on. So there was a tremendous revolution in Haiti, very, very cataclysmic, and tens of thousands of people left. Many people came to the United States to Philadelphia, to New York City, to Boston, to Baltimore. People of color, whether they were black or of mixed parentage, tended to go to New Orleans after that disaster, and some of them went to Cuba. The reason they went to Cuba is Cuba was a little bit culturally home to them. You know, it was also a Creole type of place. And they created an opera house, and I'm losing my voice. This is terrible. Hang on. They created an opera house. They had parties. They had dance. They brought all the amazing luxuries they had in Saint-Domingue to eastern Cuba, called the Oriente. And we're going to start out with a piece kind of like what you would have heard in those days. And when you hear this piece, you're going to hear some things that are echoed later in New Orleans music.
And this one is called San Pasquale Bailan. Here we go. 98.1 KZE.
Thank you.
98.1 KZE, here you are at your home for musical diversity. And I'm here today with Ken McCarthy. He's going to talk to you about what you just listened to.
And we just heard T. Ralph from the incomparable Aurora Neeland, and the Royal Roses. And that was written by Sidney Bechet, a French Creole jazz man from New Orleans. Now, when people say French Creole, they're really saying from Saint-Domingue. And when they're saying Saint-Domingue, they're saying Haiti. So a lot of this is obscured. But when somebody's French and they're in New Orleans, it's 95% chance they have ancestors from Haiti. And that's what tonight's about. It's a Haiti awareness-raising event. We're playing music, we're having fun, but we're also remembering our brothers and sisters in Haiti who are suffering terribly right now. It's the holiday season. I know there are people listening to this who are in a habit of giving to help others, and this would be a very good thing to contribute to this year. There's Oxfam, there's Doctors Without Borders, there's a wonderful grassroots group called the Lambiefund.org, and you might find another group that resonates with you, but this is the time to help our brothers and sisters in Haiti. Before that, we heard Aurora again with the Royal Roses doing Hongo Fongo. And before that, Camellia, the Panorama Jazz Band. And before that, a piece of music that you would have likely heard in Saint-Domingue way, way back when. It moved to East Cuba after the big revolution. The name of the piece was called San Pasquale Ballon.
Beautiful. And, you know, we're all connected, and you hear how the music connects back and connects forward. And as you said, Ken, it is a time of year when we feel grateful for the gifts that came our way. Especially for me, I know this great music, so I really appreciate that you're here talking about Haiti, and we're enjoying the music, and there will be more right after this here at 98.1 KZE, WKZE.com, and it's all your home for musical diversity. And you're tuned to Saturday Gumbo. I'm Susan Shaw with you until 7 o'clock tonight when Corey comes in, and I'm joined by my co-program host tonight, Ken McCarthy, and he's going to let you know what's coming up in the next set.
Great, and we're talking tonight about the Haitian influence on New Orleans, and it's huge. If you've ever been to New Orleans and marveled at the parades in the second line, that is a French Creole tradition. It came to New Orleans from Saint-Domingue, which is what we now call Haiti. If you love the fine food, the over-the-top, incredible food that makes everybody gain 20 pounds when they're in New Orleans,
yeah,
that's coming from the French Creoles, which comes from Haiti. If you like the idea of having a lot of music all the time, everywhere you go, that goes straight back to Saint-Domingue. Saint-Domingue was called the West, Paris of the West, Pearl of the Antilles. And they had, it was a party culture. It was a luxury party, good time, music, artistic culture, even things like the fine ironwork you see in the French Quarter. That is a French thing. So we're going to hear from another Frenchman. His name is Antoine. Antoine Domino, also known as Fats Domino. And, of course, it's a tune by him. And, of course, his producer was Dave Bartholomew. Also, these are Creole guys. So when you hear that word Creole, it's French Creole from Haiti. We're going to hear Taj Mahal with the New Orleans Social Club playing My Girl Josephine.
Right here at 98.1 KZE.
Thank you. Jackie Mo El Hey, Indians are rulers on the holiday.
Meet the boys on the battlefront. Meet the boys on the battlefront. Meet the boys on the battlefront. For the wild Jabba gonna stomp the drum.
The Mardi Gras morning won't be long. Gonna play Indians on carry on. Baskets running up and down the avenue. And here come the Indians, let them through.
Boys on the battlefront, meet the boys on the battlefront, meet the boys on the battlefront. Holy wild Chappatula gonna stomp some rock.
I'm an Indian ruler from the 13th hall. Let's see if I'm who I won't be born. I walk through fire and I smell too much. Snatch the feathers from an eagle, drank pants of blood.
Meet the boys on the battlefront.
Thank you.
Tom McDermott and Evan Christopher here at 98.1 KZE. I'm here with Ken McCarthy. We were just remembering that Tom McDermott was up here right next door at the Elmendorf not that long ago. That tune was Broken Windmill. We're here talking about the roots of New Orleans music, particularly the Haitian roots today, the Caribbean and African roots, and also remembering that the Haitian people could use our support at this time after a hurricane that was not so long ago and really wreaked massive devastation there. I'm going to ask Ken to let us know about the music that we just heard.
Okay, well, we listened to Antoine Fats Domino, of course, of French Creole ancestry. And, of course, his production partner, producer partner, was Dave Bartholomew, also French Creole. When Saint-Domingue, which was the name that the French gave to Haiti when they controlled it, was going in full force, it was the most lavish place in the whole Western Hemisphere. Ballrooms, dances, opera houses, fantastic architecture, fantastic gardens, costumes, parades, all the things that we associate with New Orleans, those things came to New Orleans via the French Creoles of Saint-Domingue of Haiti. And that's why we played that piece, My Girl Josephine by Taj Mahal, who, by the way, went on a French rap at the end.
I know. I thought that was really appropriate. I'm sure he knows all about these roots. Roots matter so much to Taj Mahal, really.
And then we played Meet the Boys on the Battlefront by the Wild Chapatulas. Mardi Gras Indians. What could be more New Orleans than that? But if you look at a lot of what's going on with Mardi Gras Indians, there's a lot of echoes of Saint-Domingue, especially that elaborate beadwork. That is very typical of Haiti. You can find beadwork like that being made today in Haiti. Also, if you've ever been in New Orleans on Mardi Gras, you may have come across the North Side Skull and Bones Gang. And traditionally, they are the first to go out on Mardi Gras. They dress up as skeletons and they knock on people's doors. And that goes straight back to Haiti, to Saint-Domingue. So basically, when you're in New Orleans, you're in a place that is an echo of the culture of Saint-Domingue. In fact, my good friend, musicologist Ned Sublett, calls Saint-Domingue the Atlantis of Western music. In other words, it was this amazing place that disappeared, and the remnants of it can be heard all over, but most deeply in our beloved city, New Orleans. And we're doing this tonight to have fun, obviously, but also to remember, hey, our brothers and sisters in Haiti need us right now. Let's step up.
And why did you choose the Tom McDermott and Evan Christopher piece, The Broken Windmill?
Well, it's another Sidney Bechet piece, and I would like to tell everybody that Sidney Bechet was influenced deeply by a French Creole clarinetist named Alexandra Stelio. And by the way, how do you think the clarinet and the keyboard got to New Orleans? It didn't come from Andrew Jackson, I guarantee that. It came from the Creoles from Saint-Domingue. So that whole music culture, which New Orleans is so rich in, is a Creole culture, a French Creole culture that goes right back to Saint-Domingue culture.
Well, this is so cool for me, and this is a station of musical diversity, and I also know we have very generous listeners who like to do the right thing, so this is just perfect for this weekend. Thank you so much for listening. We're going to come back, talk to Ken one more time, and right after this at 98.1 KZE, your home for musical diversity. And you are tuned to Saturday Gumbo. I'm here with Ken McCarthy. We have one more tune from him. But I wanted to ask Ken, because the way I know him, as I said, is from Jazz on the Tube. Really a fantastic email service is how I see it. Every day a great performance from a jazz great shows up in my email box. So could you just explain what Jazz on the Tube is, maybe, and how you developed that?
Well, I really appreciate that. Thank you. There was a time when there wasn't video on the internet, and I remember distinctly when suddenly it was possible to put video on the internet, and I was thrilled because there's a lot of great classic jazz videos that I wanted to just organize for myself. And I put together a little collection of them, and then I started sharing them with friends, and they started telling friends, and next thing I knew, the thing was blowing up, basically. We now have over 40,000 active email subscribers, which makes us bigger than Downbeat.
I'm not surprised.
And every day we send out a new email pointing you to a video: Louis Armstrong, Sidney Bechet, Charlie Parker, Miles Davis, John Coltrane, you name it. We have over 2,000 videos, all annotated. And we've just started a new Cuban section, so if you want to learn about Cuban music and the history of Cuban music, you can go sign up for a free email course, and every week you get a new lesson on who's who in Cuba.
Wow. Really, jazz is such a beautiful form, and you're giving it life, so thanks for that. So Ken brought one more tune. I'm going to let him talk about that and just say thank you so much for coming tonight, for shining light on what's going on in Haiti, and for bringing this great music. Thank you.
Thank you. And again, we hope we had fun on this Thanksgiving weekend. But this was an awareness raiser about the conditions in Haiti. We love Oxfam. We love Doctors Without Borders. LambiFund.org, L-A-M-B-I, fund.org, very reliable group based in Haiti. For those of you that feel the desire to help, these are great ways to help. So let's talk about the next song that's coming up.
Okay, yeah.
The final song. This song has very rich resonance. Okay, it's called Little Liza Jane, which is a brass band traditional standard that everybody plays. How many people knew that the chorus of Little Liza Jane is probably, based on how it sounds, a West African invocation of the earth and sky?
Wonderful.
And if it came to New Orleans from West Africa, very strong odds it came via Saint-Domingue, also known as Haiti. It's a performance by Chuck Perkins and the Melody Markers, and I used to think it was called the Melody Makers.
I would have said that.
Yeah, but I don't know. I was reading the CD, and I'm a friend of Chuck's, a good friend of Chuck's, and I was reading the CD, and it said Markers, so I'm not sure if they're the Markers or the Makers. Chuck Perkins is a marvelous poet. He tells the history and the story of New Orleans with beautiful music behind him. This is a version of Little Liza Jane, and here's where it's relevant to our situation. In this piece here, he celebrates the rebuilding of New Orleans, and he shouts out to all the musicians who brought the spirit back, because the spirit came back first, and then the city was rebuilt, and it was the musicians who brought the spirit back. I think most people know New Orleans got a tremendous amount of help from the outside to rebuild, and it's fitting that we end with this song to remind ourselves of all the people that came to New Orleans to help, and also to remind ourselves of all the help that's needed in Haiti today.
Yeah, that's perfect. So I know you're traveling to Cuba and New Orleans soon. I hope I'll see you back when you come home, or even call from there.
Okay. Okay, I'll bring some stories.
Okay, thanks, Ken. Here's Little Liza Jane by Chuck Perkins and the Melody Markers.
There is some dude. This is
is for my artist of virtuosity who kept the music in the mystery. It's for my artistic vanguard who came back when times were hard, who sometimes came back to nothing but still came back underrated and uninsured, put their horns where their mouth is. This is for my buck-jumping Pied Pipers who gon' second line my people all the way back home. This poem's for you. This is for my melody makers, for my cowbell ringers and my tambourine shakers. This is for the lady buck jumpers, for the rebirth brass band and the Storyville stumpers, for the soul rebels and the hottie, for the little rascals wanting to dime when all they got is eight. It's for Kermit Ruffin and the barbecue swingers, for Marva Wright and all my blues singers, for making that music that heal our pain. It's for Shannon Powell and Lil Liza Jane. I got Liza, you got Liza, we got Liza. I'm from the Noya and I thought I told you. It's for the Golden Comanches and the Wild Magnolia. For loving our city, we ain't giving up an inch. It's for Stanton Moore, Bob, and George French. We love her scat and we love her razzle dazzle. It's for Urban Mayfield and Jermaine Basil. It's for Dr. Michael White for keeping it tight. And for Uncle Lionel, still raising hell. We sure gonna miss him when we die. It's for Troy Sawyer and Kevin O'Day. Kid Chocolate Brown and John Butte. For Dave Torkanowski and Walter Wolfman. Trombone Shorty and the whole Andrews clan and the Marcellus clan and the Baptiste clan too. Shermaine Neville, this poem's for you. And don't forget Kid Jordan and the whole Jordan crew. It's for Philip Manuel and Leah Chase, Earl and Riley on drums, Roland Garrett on bass. Holla if you hear me. It's for Corey Henry on trombone, Kirk Joseph on sousaphone, Donald Harrison on sax. I take off my hat to Benny Jones and Leroy Jones and all our musicians who came back home. This poem's for you. We'll work today if you play tonight. Sing us a song that make us all right. The sounds of your horns give us strength to fight. We'll gut the houses if you play your sax. We'll swing the hammer if you swing your axe. We'll work with haste as you play your drum. Please bring your bass and we'll have some fun. Run with the sounds as hot as the sun. Ba-dum-bum-bum-bum, play your drum. Suck it down your gun, let's have some fun. We're doing the day, but when the nighttime comes, oh, Liza,